Hey friends, it is baby goat time once again. Forgive my fingers, I was using some blue coat. That's really funny. Okay, I just won't use my fingers. Hey friends, ready or not, it is baby goat time once again. I have a mama who was due tomorrow and checked her ligaments this morning and they were still there, so I knew we had some time. Well, during my milking chores, I heard some noises and I looked over and she is pushing. So ligaments or not, ready or not, she's pushing these babies out today. She is pushing. Bella, you are giving me no time at all. Okay, Oswin, will you hold my camera and point it at her?
I gotta grab my dog.
That other is dead.
Oswin, you're doing great. Sorry,
dog. Keep pushing. No, you can't push while standing up.
Oh, of course you can.
Really? But the baby will fall. Thank you, Bella.
We had a huge thunderstorm last night, so everything is soggy and wet and muddy. And so at least it's warm. I mean, that's the only plus. And we have nice dry stalls. But oh my goodness, I was not prepared for this first thing in the morning today. That's okay, we're gonna do our best. Thankfully, nature really can handle its own on birth for the most part. So we're really just here to supervise and step in if something happens, like an emergency.
I know.
Keep on pushing.
I had plans to put her on the stand and get her some breakfast and check her ligaments again and trim her hooves because she's on the docket for trimming hooves today. And yet here we are instead in the birth stall with hay on your nose.
Good girl. It's coming out.
That's right. It's time. Wow, you gave us no warning, Bella. You gave us no warning here, Bella. Good girl. Oh my goodness. Good girl, Bella. So good. Oh, there's a sweet baby. There we go. Good girl. Yep, perfect position. Good girl. You got this. Good girl, Bella.
It's out.
It's out. You gotta give it a little push, and then you can lick it off.
You don't have ligaments. You shouldn't be pushing the baby out.
I know. What on earth, girly? Push it out the rest.
Push
it out. There you go. Now you can lick your baby. Oh my goodness, how precious.
Don't leave a mess. If you leave a mess, then Bella's gonna eat it.
Oh, beautiful. Oh my goodness. Can you imagine if we'd milked an hour later today?
Yeah.
You got baby on the ground over there. Oh, you look just like your mommy.
This little baby's a
boy
or girl.
Let's find out. Excuse me, Bella. Can I take a peek at your baby here? Oh, a pretty girl.
Name ideas?
I don't know. I haven't even thought about it. Okay, so this is a perfect example of why we keep really good records on goats and how they labor. Because most goats will lose their ligaments and then start labor after that, or the really active portion of labor. And so you normally, once they lose ligaments, have 12 to 24 hours is a good range before babies are on the ground. Bella had ligaments 30 minutes ago. So I have got to write in her notes that ligaments don't mean much to her. But I did notice this morning that her udder was huge and totally full. So for this goat, I need to watch her udder, not necessarily her ligaments. So this is the first time she's had a kid with us here on our farm. So this is all new. But as long as I keep good records, I'll know it for next year.
Bella was pretty big. I really think she might have another one in there.
Is it time to push another baby out?
Yeah.
think it is.
Bella is being such a good mom. In between each contraction, she takes a break so she can go lick her first baby. She's already doing a great job. I see some hooves. If she has a hard time, then I'll burst the bubble. But otherwise, I like to leave it intact if I can. And she's doing a great job. Good girl. Though that is a lot of pressure. They bust violently. All right, Bella. Oh, look at those ears. All right, push her out.
Push it out.
That's true. Push it out. Could be a boy.
Okay, who is it?
It is identical. Oh my goodness, you look just the same as your sibling.
Probably because Bella and Ellen are so similar.
They are quite similar, aren't they? Oh my goodness. It is beautiful. Alright, let's see. Looks like two girls.
Good girl, Bella.
That's right.
What name should we give them?
Oh, that was a very good girl, Bella. They're so beautiful, Bella. Someone is very hungry already.
She was hungry when she was born.
She was. Mama's still cleaning off your sister. You gotta give her a minute.
She's pushing.
She's pushing?
Be a third girl.
To make up for...
Sequoias.
Are you seriously pushing a third one out? Oh my goodness, she's pushing a third one out.
Be a girl to make up for silly Madeline's three babies.
Three boys, that's right.
We need three girls.
Now wait, was that just a water bag? And you're just making us panic? Or do you actually have a third one in there?
I hope it's a third one.
Oh my goodness, of course you do. All right, give me a minute. You haven't pushed it out yet. So normally, babies come quickly and placenta takes a little while to come. So the fact that she just pushed out number two and she's already trying to push again makes me wonder if there's a third one or is she just going ahead and delivering her placenta very quickly? Not sure, so we're going to keep watching. So typically what I've seen in my goats, at least, is they lose their placenta about an hour or two after the babies get up and start nursing. So that tends to be what triggers hormones and contractions to keep going, is them nursing, and that gets things moving so the placenta comes out. So the fact that nobody's nursed yet makes me think we might have a third baby, but it's hard to know. You going in for the drink?
Yeah, that was number one who
said that. That's right.
I can tell because it has a red tongue.
Well, they both have red tongues. But really? I see her spot. Number one had a spot. All right, I think we're pushing a third one out.
Yeah, we're pushing a third one out.
That's a third one. Goodness, Bella. I cannot believe you have three babies.
That means we get to have a
mom. Oh my goodness. Bella.
Sorry for the shaky cam, guys. I don't have anywhere to put the camera. I feel that.
Be careful. If you sit down,
there we go. There we go. Oh my goodness. All right, push, 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 Bella. Push, push, push. Don't turn. Push.
She's trying to reach her.
Push, push, push. There you go. That was good. I know, and they're identical.
We are girls.
How are we going to tell these guys apart?
But two of them are girls.
Well, what if all three are girls?
Well, you can't call them guys.
No, that's true. Hi, little one. Oh, Bella. How dare you have three babies? Oh, my goodness. Let's back that up a little bit. All right, moment of truth. You ready for this?
Who is it? Is it girls?
It's a girl!
Three girls!
You guys, that is insanity. She just had three nearly identical girls. Oh my goodness. Crazy. Bella, do you see the mischief you have created here? Oh my goodness. Yeah, lick your babies. You got a lot to take care of here, girl. Oh my goodness. Okay, so number three has the lighter markings above her eyes. So they do have slightly different color patterns.
I think number one is starting to look like Ellen now that she's drying off.
They do always change as they dry. Oh my goodness, you guys.
Insanity.
Yes, this is insanity. I cannot believe she just had triplet doelings.
It makes up for Madeline's three boys.
It's true. It makes up for the three boys, but oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Crazy.
Did somebody figure it out? Say no, but we're trying. Oh, you fell down. Better angle from down there, huh, little one?
I know Mama has a big udder.
Oh my goodness. Can you guys check on him? Why don't I get you some breakfast?
You could use the three fairies.
That's a cute idea.
Yeah.
Laura, Fauna, and Meriwether.
I couldn't remember them.
That's a cute idea.
I can only remember Meriwether.
Wow, you guys. What a very fast and furious, exciting morning it's been. We are thrilled to have three new doelings on the farm. And Bella is actually half-sister to one of the grand champions from the Mini Nubian show in the past few years. So she comes from some phenomenal milk lines. So we're super excited about her babies. The only downside of the morning is this all happened in the middle of milking. So unfortunately our milk sat there for a couple of hours, and that really means that it's not gonna be safe for us to consume. So no worries, we have piggies who will love to help us out with that problem. So I'm a little bit bummed that I lost the milk for the day, but no complaints from the pigs. All right, we're back over in the barn, and we ended up moving Bella to a different stall. We had her in one of our kidding stalls, which are really nice. They're very small, so mom and babies are kept close together. But with the rain last night,
It was just a little bit soggy. You know, the top layer of shavings was really nice and dry, but when I sat there long enough, I noticed my pants were starting to get wet, and that means the ground has moisture. And when you're talking about brand new babies, we want to make sure that they are staying warm and dry. And so that little bit of moisture seeping in from the ground could present some problems. So, easy fix, we just moved them over to a different stall where we knew the ground was not wet at all. We even put down some fresh shavings just so that they had a really, really dry, warm spot to be. Now, if you've been around our channel for very long, you may know that we've recently, as in like earlier this year, had to make a new rule. And that rule is mamas are only allowed to have two babies. We sadly lost some babies this year to moms who had three and just couldn't keep up with milk production to feed them well enough. That or the small one was getting kicked off the teat. We're just really not sure, but whatever it was that happened, there were some babies that didn't make it because they weren't getting the milk they needed, and we think it was because there were three. So we have a rule, and that is mamas only get two babies. If they have more than two babies, somebody's getting the bottle. So we've already picked out which of these three seems to be a little bit smaller and struggle a little bit more, and she's gonna be a bottle baby for us. That's this sweet girl right here. She is really precious. She was actually the first one born from Bella, but she just seems to be the small one. She's having a hard time getting milk, and so she's gonna be bottle fed. All right, so introductions are in order. We had a little bit of a hard time deciding what names we wanted to go with, but Oswin thought of the three fairies from Sleeping Beauty. So we have Flora, Fauna, and Meriwether. And all three of these girls are precious. We are so excited about them. This birth was definitely one of the more exciting ones, although it was quite quick and short. It was a full whirlwind for sure, because we very nearly missed this whole birth. We would have finished milking and gone inside. If she had been 10 minutes later, we would have just missed it, because she had so much ligaments still felt and just pushed those babies right out. So crazy that we almost missed it. I'm so glad we didn't. But we are gonna enjoy these sweet babies, and we'll catch you guys in the next video. Don't forget, we have pig mamas due soon. Thankfully, we have a little bit of a break before we have more goat mamas, but come the first week of April, we have five that are due back to back to back. So it's gonna get crazy over here. But don't forget to hit subscribe, leave us a comment. We'd love to hear from you guys. Thanks for watching. You girls are precious.
Oh my goodness. Can I just show how pretty you are?
She is so gorgeous. She is so gorgeous. So I'm gonna give you guys a close up to see how pretty. See those pretty blue eyes? Oh, you're gorgeous.